make a reservation, don a life jacket, and cruise over the Chesapeake Bay from a small dock on Tillman Island, and you'll discover a little-known but critical piece of Maryland's landscape that was nearly lost to history. This is Poplar Island. This once political retreat boasted 1,100 acres when it was first surveyed in 1847. By 1993, all but 5 acres had disappeared below the waves, due largely to erosion. The state of Maryland partnered with the Army Corps of Engineers to rescue the important wildlife habitat. With marshes and water channels spilling into the bay and limited access for predators, the island is a safe harbor for fish, shellfish, and bird species. Every year, the island also welcomes about 1,000 hatchlings of the state reptile, the terrapin. Crews have been dredging the Port of Baltimore's approach channels and using the material to reconstruct Poplar Island. The overall project will take 68 million cubic yards of dredged material. Today it is back up to its original 1,100 acres, but the work continues to grow the island by another 575. The plan is to build the island to last, adding higher elevation points, a rock perimeter, and some trees. While work continues, it's open for public tours, and Horn Point Laboratory's biological oceanography students joined the first tour of 2017. Along for the trip was Lori Staver, an assistant research scientist from Horn Point, who discussed UMCES' role on the island.
We are monitoring the elevation in the marshes, and that's really critical because marshes are right almost at sea level. So as sea level rises, which it has been on average since the last glaciation, but we're expecting it to increase that rate of elevation change, sea level rise, the marshes have to increase their elevation to keep up with sea level rise or they'll drown. And this is occurring in all over the world. As sea level rises, we're losing marshes. They're eroding away, they're drowning and then eroding away. So we're monitoring very carefully the elevation out here using a technology called surface or sediment elevation tables. And we can measure the elevation change very precisely. And we're working with the Corps of Engineers, who also does some elevation monitoring using more traditional methods, and looking at the drivers of the elevation change in here, what's contributing to elevation change, inorganic sediment that's coming in from the bay and being trapped in the marshes, biomass production, organic deposition from the plants themselves, that sort of thing. So those are
Judy O'Neill, an associate research professor at Horn Point, has been taking her class to Poplar Island for years.
We do this because biological oceanography encompasses coastal oceanography and macrophytes, including seagrasses, SAB, macroalgae, and marshes are really important primary producers in the coastal zone. So it's all connected.